What up, y'all? Lupe Fiasco here. Just with a quick super fact about voting and the Democratic Party and the Republican Party and black people's aversion to the Republican Party. I just want to remind you, right, that the Republican Party, and whatever incarnation you want to put it in, people haven't forgot. Living people who vote, black people who vote, living, have not forgot about Richard Nixon. And the wild shit that he said about black people. And the wild shit that he's done about. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't get it confused. People have long memories and they ain't forgot. And the Republican Party has a crazy history when it comes to black folk and what they say and how they treat them. So don't just take it as black people stupid because the Democrats is lying to them. We know they lying to us. But y'all, the Republican Party been lying to motherfuckers too. So, just be clear, man. We ain't forgot. Right, and just to continue, right? People say, "Oh, it's a different party, it's a different time." I mean, the Democrats advocated for slavery way back 150 years ago, 200 years ago, and the Republican Party actually was fighting against. And then there was the switch, right? Where they basically just swapped names, right? I'm talking about now. I'm talking about today. Today, right? You see the wild shit that is coming out of people's mouths today on the GOP side of things. I mean, fair shot. People throwing shots all over the place. Democrats saying some crazy shit. But it's like the burden of proof is on the Republicans. Like, y'all have a history that is painted by figures who are fucking nuts. And y'all still haven't embodied that. And y'all just still continue to compound it with more wild ass people. It's nuts. So in closing, man, how about this? Forget the names. Forget Democrat. Forget Republican. Blindfold. Yeah? Don't see white. Don't see black. See the policies that people put in place. Just vote on policy, man. If a person put out a certain policy that agree with you and your personal goals or the goals that you have set out for your community, then vote for that. Be prepared, and you prepared to accept the consequences and all of the tertiary and third and second and third order effects of that policy coming into place, whether it be some domestic or international or economic or cultural or whatever. If you cool with that, then so be it. You know, vote for what you feel is the best policy for the well-being of yourself and your family and your people. And whatever side of the line it fall on, and that's just what it is. It's certain things you're going to agree with on one side, certain things you ain't going to agree with your opposition, and vice versa. But don't get it confused. Don't play like we don't know why we don't fuck with y'all. And just a little tiny PS about consequences of policy. Understand that there are people in this world that are smarter than you, that do more research than you, and that they may have a better understanding of the effect of something over time that you may not have. And maybe you should listen to their advice or at least peruse their research with a certain clarity and a certain honesty, right, about the consequences of that. Because you might have a great short term. You might have a great opening act, right? But your middle game and your closing might be trash. And unfortunately, when it comes to policy that deals with human lives, you can't have your end game can't be trash. It has to be strong. Now, whether you Democrat, Republican, socialist, communist, whatever, if it's people around who have that insight and that outsight, maybe you should listen to them instead of yourself.